guys, and welcome back to another video. This is my reborn painting tutorial part two. Yay! I'm so excited to finally be able to get this video out for you guys. Just some quick things. I'm gonna try not to talk as much, I promise. But you will notice in this video that the painting I'm showing you isn't necessarily in sequential order. I just want to get that out there. There are parts of my reborning stages that are like not in order of these videos, so you'll see the coloring or your detail work of this baby kind of change throughout this video, and that's just because the first video was all about, you know, undertones and mottling, where this video is just about detail work. But these videos aren't necessarily in the order that I actually make a reborn. It's just showing you the different parts of reborning. Anyway, I hope that makes sense, but I'm gonna stop talking and get right into this video. So for starters, I am doing creases, and you will see that I kind of take this purpley maroonish type color. It's a really like deep red with purple undertones, and I use that for my creasing. So again, I premix colors, and I'm going into my jar of my creasing color with a fine details brush to put that color in the crease, as you can see here, the eyelids, and then taking that flat small brush to blend it out, making it like an airbrush effect. You want the creases to be known, but you don't want them to be harsh. You want to make sure you're blending them out, and this goes for everywhere you're putting the creases. And then in some places, like around the nose that I'm doing now, I'm going to go back and do those creases multiple times because I do want them dark, but you still always want to like brush them out. You don't want them to be harsh like just paint. Anyways, so I'm going to let you guys watch this video and see where I put the creases, and I will come back to you for the next part of details. Jump in and remind you to not forget the inside of the nostrils. I know that that is definitely something I didn't think about when I first started reborning, but it is very crucial and will definitely add to that realistic look if you do the inside of the nostrils as well. And I also didn't film it, but I did go back and took the end of a brush and dipped it in some black and then put it in the nostrils as well and then blended it out just to give it more depth. Or some people take a drill and open the nostrils. I personally am not comfortable doing that, but if that's something you want to do, you can do that as well. And I also wanted to say this part right here, this is where I'm starting the mouth. So I am still learning how to do open mouths, I'm not going to lie. But this, I just took that same crease color and started the first layer in there. I'll do the tongue with this color and then also the gums. And I'll do some more of the mouth later, but just wanted to throw that in there and give you a base, just to kind of help you realize how to do that, I guess. Just give a little bit more detail without you just having to watch it. But anyway, we're going to continue with creases for now. So I'm doing the ear, and yeah, I'll let you guys watch. So this is where I am going into that mouth again. So I'm getting a pinky, again like maroony color from the back of my tray, and I'm just putting this on the lips. I will do several layers of this, and I did not film all the layers because it was exhausting trying to build up the perfect lip color, or the perfect lip color that I wanted for this baby. I don't think there is such thing as a perfect lip color. But anyway, so I'm taking that color and I'm just using a very tiny, not a detail brush, it's kind of fluffy, and just putting that on the lips with that brush. And then I will later take a angled flat brush and just blend that color out. I usually start by blending it away from the nose, and then later you'll see that that color will like create this line on the lips if you blend it both ways to really get that smooth, natural lip. So this is what the baby looks like after the first layer of lip color. And now I'm gonna go in with some rashy details on the cheeks. So this is actually a very easy technique to do. I take a sea sponge, it was blurry, but sort of like this, and I go into the top of my blush color that I showed you in my first tutorial, and I'm just gonna pounce the sea sponge all over the baby's face wherever I want a newborn rashy look, and then take the sponge and blend it out. And that's it. It's super easy, super simple, and it's a great technique to use. After you have done some of that rashy look on the cheeks, if you want to refine some of those details and make some like baby pimples, this is what I do. So I use a toothpick, and as you saw, I just dabbed it wherever I wanted a blemish, and then I'm gonna take that same brush I used for the lips and kind of dab it out. You want it to look a little bit natural, and you can see I take my finger and just kind of get the excess off. And this is sort of what it looks like afterwards. And you can do this all over. I will do these on the cheeks, on the temples, under the eyes, wherever I want little blemishes. And then you can also go in with the toothpick and do white as well to create those little baby like white heads. And the same thing for the milk bumps. You'll see I will use a toothpick for that as well. Decided to go in with the brush and do the milk bumps on this baby. I thought I used the toothpick, but no, I'm using the brush, sorry. So I'm just using a very, very tiny detail brush, and I'm going in with, it's not just white that I'm using, it's actually a white mixed with a tan and yellow, and I am using that for the milk bumps. So this is what it looks like once I've put those on, but don't worry, they're not going to be this harsh. I'm going to take a sponge, and pounce those out, kind of rub them a little bit, because you don't want milk bumps to be just like white dots on the face. And I don't think I filmed this part either, but I'm actually going to go in later and take some varnish on a toothpick and go over those milk bumps to make them 3D so you can actually fill them as well. So now it is finally time for some peach fuzz baby hairs. I think it's called Lanugo, or maybe something that starts with a V. I can't remember, but anyways, I am taking this brush that I have actually cut up and created these very fine lines, sort of like a V shape, and I'm going in with some tannish white on this brush, and it's not really liquidy, not super transparent, but it's not like super thick either. Anyway, so I'm taking that on this brush, and I am basically just going to lightly, and I mean lightly, you want to have a light hand for this, and just rub it, not rub it, but like stroke it all over this baby's face or wherever you want this peach fuzz baby hair. Some people don't do this step at all. Some people only do it on the forehead. I recently have been doing it all over, but it just depends on the baby, just depends on the artist, you know, whatever. I don't do it on all the babies, but recently I've been doing it. So anyway, yep, that's what I'm gonna be doing. And again, just like the milk bumps, this is going to look very, very harsh when I'm done, and I'll show you that in a second. But just like with the milk bumps, I'm going to rub this out with a sponge. And I promise you the finished product is not going to look as harsh. But in just a second, when you see the completed baby with all of the white peach fuzz on it, it's going to look like a little white Wolverine. So yeah, I just wanted to let you guys know not to worry. Once you blend it out and bake it, it will lighten up a lot, but you do want to make sure that you lighten it up and bake it, or else you are going to have these white lines all over the baby's face like this. That does not look natural. So this is what I was talking about. But again, as you'll see once I am done doing this and baking it, that it will not look like this in the end.
I forgot to film an outro, so I'm filming it really quick on my phone, so forgive me. But thank you guys so much for watching. I am just so happy to be able to do these videos for you guys. Please let me know what other videos you would like to see in the comments below. I'm running out of ideas. I'm actually currently editing part 3 of the painting tutorials, which will be the hair painting tutorial, and I'm super excited to get that video out for you guys. It's a little different than these because filming a hair painting tutorial is a lot harder than like a regular painting tutorial, but I hope you guys will get it and you'll still like it either way. Thank you also, thank you for the almost 200 subscribers. That is crazy to me, especially considering that I just started this YouTube channel, so truly thank you. But make sure you share, because when I get to 1,000, one of you guys will be winning a full completed reborn painted by myself, which is so exciting. And I'm actually starting that baby this weekend, so if you want to see updates on that baby, make sure you follow my Instagram, which is also at Doodlehead Nursery. And then of course, when he or she is finished, I will post the video on here as well and draw a winner. But in the meantime, yes, share so we can get to 1,000 and one of you can win him or her. But yeah, anyway, thank you guys so much, and I will see you guys in the next video. Bye guys.